Good day, campers. Today I want to talk a little about RV driver license. One of the most frequently asked questions on RV forums is, what kind of driver license do I need to drive my RV? The answer is two parts. The first part is simple. It depends on the laws in your state of residency. For weekend campers, this is the state where you live. For full-timers, this is your domicile state. The second part is a bit more complicated. It's often difficult to get a clear answer from the local DMV. The number one thing to remember is, whatever kind of license your home state requires must and will be honored in the other 49 states. Similar to a marriage license, if you get married in Arizona, the other 49 states will honor that license. If your driver license is issued in Arizona, the other 49 states will honor that license. This is not the case when it comes to length and double tow laws. That is decided by each state, regardless of what state you are licensed in, and applies to anyone traveling in or through that state. The second thing to remember, with one or two very limited exceptions, is you do not need a CDL, which stands for Commercial Driver's License, to operate your RV for your private use. A CDL is for those who get paid to operate a commercial vehicle, not for private citizens driving their personal vehicle for private use. At the time of this video, the state of Washington has only two classes of driver license. One for all vehicles up to a certain weight, I believe 26K, and anything above that does require a CDL because they have no non-commercial equivalent. Most of the other states have several licenses, and if they require a special license to operate an RV, it will be some kind of non-commercial license. It is your responsibility to be properly licensed for the vehicle you are operating. You hear lots of people say law enforcement doesn't bother RVers, and that does tend to be the case. Where it becomes a problem is in the event of an accident. If you are not properly licensed, the chances are you will be cited by the responding officers, and depending on the accident, you could find yourself in civil court responding to a lawsuit. So how in the world are you supposed to figure out what kind of license you need? First, talk to people in your state with equipment similar to yours. Ask what kind of license do they have and how did they find out what to get. Second, contact the local DMV office and ask them. Third, and actually the best choice, pick up a DMV handbook. These study guides will have in the front a list of the different licenses and what types of equipment they apply to. You will find there is a wide range of licensing requirements that vary from state to state, so the only state's law that matters to you is the laws in the state that issues your driver's license. It does no good to ask on Facebook because you will get dozens of answers and chances are only a very small number of them will apply to you. I hope I was able to help answer most of your driver licensing questions. Thanks for listening, and please remember to like and subscribe.